Set between the rivers Dee and Mersey, the Wirral Peninsula flows into the Liverpool Bay and the Irish Sea. It's an area with stunning natural attractions and a rich heritage, and today home to more than 300,000 people and some of the best known companies in the country and the world. From refined golf courses to a wild and unspoilt coastline, it is a unique area, a place to work, rest and play. But what about Wirral's future? And what are the opportunities for the generations to come? Hi, I'm Carly Stenson, and I'm here to show you what the future holds for the Wirral. I also want to tell you about the 7 major job sectors that are going to help create local employment for young people leaving schools, colleges, universities, now and for decades to come. And what better place to start our journey than here, where the land meets the sea. Wirral has an ancient maritime heritage, dating back to the arrival of the Vikings through to the industrialisation and shipbuilding on Wirral's Mersey waterfront. Today's Merseyside maritime industry is one of the fastest growing employment sectors in the region. Maritime jobs already bring millions into the local economy each year. More than 1,000 companies are already working in the sector, providing more than 26,000 jobs. By 2025, the maritime sector will have benefited from £270 million worth of investment as part of the Merseyport's growth strategy. And all that expansion means a lot more jobs across a wide range of different professions.
The maritime sector on Merseyside consists of more than 1,000 companies who employ 26,000 staff with an annual turnover of £2.5 billion. It's a thriving, important sector represented by the Mersey Maritime Group. We collectively are very keen to encourage quality young recruits into the sector where there are excellent opportunities for jobs and job development.
The next sector I want to talk to you about is engineering. We've already seen that there are jobs available for engineers in the maritime industry, but engineers will find that they're in demand across a wide range of different industries. Engineering is the practical application of science. Engineers are involved in the research and development, design, manufacturing, and production of the machinery, products, and systems of everyday life, from cars to hospital equipment, from computers to drilling rigs, from alternative energy to communication systems. People work in engineering at all levels, ranging from those who operate machinery and carry out assembly work, to professional engineers who use their experience to manage projects. Jobs may be indoors, in an office or factory, or outdoors. Around 1.5 million people work in engineering-related jobs for large and small-scale manufacturing companies, specialist engineering workshops, public utilities such as electricity companies, and product design and development companies. Skilled people are highly sought after, and opportunities, especially for those with flexible skills or a strong grasp of new technology, are growing. Engineering jobs exist throughout the UK and abroad. Around 20% of engineering employees are female, but there is a need for more women to join the industry, particularly in professional engineering roles. Engineering jobs require people who like maths and science, enjoy finding solutions to challenging problems, and are practical and good communicators. Entry is possible through a number of different routes, including apprenticeships and the new diplomas. Engineering work offers excellent training and development prospects. There's also opportunities to improve your skills through further and higher education, giving you additional qualifications which can lead to higher salaried jobs.
Our third key sector is construction. After all this expansion, we need the type of people who can create us exciting places to work and live.
The construction industry deals with a wide range of work, from everyday things like installing windows, fitting carpets, and mending burst pipes, to creating exciting buildings such as new entertainment stadiums, hotels, and conference centres. The industry employs people with a variety of skill levels. They include operatives, skilled craftspeople, technicians, and professionals such as civil engineers and surveyors. They are involved in all aspects of construction, including planning, design, surveying, project management, building and fitting, inspection, renovation, and repair and maintenance. Currently, there is a particular shortage of workers with the technical skills to enter professions such as architecture, project management, building, and quantity surveying. Craftspeople need practical hand skills for using tools and machinery. Technicians and those working at professional level require scientific understanding, as well as ability in IT and maths, while others such as architects would expect creative skills.
it is possible to enter via apprenticeships or the new diploma, and you can work through the senior positions using a combination of experience and qualifications acquired along the way. There's also opportunities to improve your skills through traditional education routes, such as further and higher education, giving you the additional qualifications to lead to higher salaried jobs.
They say that retail therapy is a pick-me-up, and I certainly agree. But have you ever stopped to think about the sheer size and scale of the retail job sector and the opportunities it will provide as investment rolls into the Wirral?
There are almost 70,000 people employed in the retail sector across Merseyside. Major developments are already underway to transform Liverpool's waterfront, and there will be major developments around Wirral's waterways. New rail freight terminals are being created to develop Merseyside's ability to import and export goods across the UK and the rest of the world. It's an exciting time, calling for talented people in a wide range of retail jobs. In fact, almost 7,000 new jobs are likely to be created between now and 2015, just in the retail sector alone. But what do I mean by retail? Well, anything that ultimately offers a service to a customer, from creating and designing a new fashion range to selling products in a department store. So whether you're looking for a role in manufacturing or direct sales or planning a career in management or marketing, the retail industry may be for you. Employers range from small independent companies to huge multinational businesses with branches all over the world. Getting into a retail job demands a wide range of skills, which vary depending on the type of career you are looking to pursue. Pathways include apprenticeships and the new diplomas. Some employers offer in-house training, and the retail sector has also created its own training academy to develop training programs and skills. And you can also enter further and higher education and gain the qualifications necessary to enter specialised retail positions. Okay, I've got my new outfit sorted and I'm ready to enjoy myself, which is where the next sector comes in. Like the retail sector, hospitality and tourism provide many job opportunities.
Just think about how you and your family like to enjoy your leisure time. You may like to watch or play sports, go for fancy meals, get pampered, and of course we all love to go away on holiday, whether it's just for short weekends away or trips to foreign shores.
Anyone who watches TV these days will realise how popular food and drink programmes have become. Hospitality is a massive job sector, providing a range of careers from being a chef through to running a large city hotel or sports stadium.
Tourism has a shared aim of helping people to enjoy their leisure time. It is an industry that is fast moving and constantly changing and developing.
So whether you would like to be a holiday representative, run your own golf course, or become a travel agent, there's always a career here for you.
Pursuing a career in these sectors varies on the type of job you want to do. It is possible to enter via apprenticeships or the new diploma, and you can work through the senior positions using a combination of experience and qualifications acquired along the way. There's also opportunities to improve your skills through traditional educational routes, such as further and higher education, giving you the additional qualifications to lead to higher salaried jobs.
Our next growth sector is public service.
Public service jobs are focused on making people safe. There is a diverse range of jobs available. The police and prison services, officers, instructors, crime and forensic investigators, and community support officers work closely together to prevent and detect crimes and in educating and rehabilitating offenders. There's fire and rescue services, which include firefighters and Coast Guard incident response and rescue teams. Then there's the Army, Navy and Royal Air Force, working both at home and overseas, and private security, close protection officers, private investigators, store detectives and security officers are on constant alert, protecting people and premises. Today, technology is being used more often, particularly in intelligence gathering to help anticipate potentially dangerous situations. This means there are more office-based roles, but most work involves a great deal of challenging physical outdoor work. Entry and training requirements depend on the occupation and the level of entry. Each service offers structured and continuous training. For those looking to develop public service careers, apprenticeships or the new diploma are available, as well as further and higher education qualifications, which may lead to higher salaried jobs. The last growth sector I want to talk about is health and social care. Workers in healthcare are concerned with the health and well-being of people. As well as caring for those who are ill, there are opportunities to investigate new and better treatments and to educate people about healthier lifestyles.
There are a wide range of occupations from doctors and dentists, nurses, midwives and health visitors, through to other professionals such as physiotherapists, dietitians and radiographers. There's also opportunities for those who want to work as healthcare scientists, working in the prevention, diagnosis and treatment of illnesses. And there are roles for health administrators who work with patient information and records and managers who make sure that services are delivered efficiently and within budget. There are many different working environments, including hospitals and clinics, daycare centres and residential homes, GP surgeries, laboratories, pharmacies, opticians and dental practices. Entry is possible through a number of different routes, including NHS cadetships, apprenticeships and the new diplomas, while some specialised positions will require university courses. Whatever route you choose, the health and social care sector offers excellent training and development prospects. There's also opportunities to improve your skills, giving you additional qualifications, which can lead to higher salaried jobs. So there you have it, our quick peek into the future. Wirral can expect major growth in 7 key employment sectors that will offer local young people at school and college great opportunities across a wide range of professions. All of these sectors offer entry routes through apprenticeships and diplomas.
Wirral is changing. The opportunities being created here are far-reaching and exciting for anyone planning a future career. It really is a great place to be. But remember, today's employers are looking for the staff with qualifications and training to meet their business needs. That's where apprenticeships and diplomas can help, identifying the career prospects available for the years to come and preparing a workforce that meets the demands of the future.